Breaking news. Buhari planted animosity between Nigerians. See reasons below. More than ever in the history of Nigeria, there's a growing necessity about the continued corporate existence of the country, with calls for breakup by individuals and groups assuming an unprecedented proportion, while allegations of marginalization in appointments and other forms of nepotism leveled against President Muhammadu Buhari's administration are at the center of the protest of the dissenting voices. The call for restructuring has the only condition for the controllability of the country is also gathered momentum. The first term of President Muhammadu Buhari was majorly characterized by certain concerns over alleged pop-sided appointments, which often generated controversies among stakeholders. It was believed that major appointments into the security architecture of the country is particularly and management positions in other areas of life were skewed in favor of a particular section of the country. This, from time to time, attracted condemnation by the Christians Association of Nigeria, CAN, Pan Igbo Social Cultural Group, Oaneze Ndi Igbo, and Pan Yoruba Social Political Group, and also Afeniferi, Southern and Middle Belt Forum, and Pandef, with lamentations of government's insensitivity to the federal character principle. However, after receiving his certificate of return from the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, as the winner of the February 23, 2019 presidential election, President Muhammadu Buhari pledged to run an exclusive government in his second term. I therefore want to assure that we will continue to engage all parties that have the best interests of Nigerians at heart. Our government will remain exclusive and our doors will remain open, the president had stated. That is the way to build the country of our dream. Safe, secure, prosperous, and free of impunity and primitive accumulations by those entrusted with public offices. The hard work to deliver a better Nigerian continues, building on the foundation of peace, rule of law, and opportunities for all. We all roll up our sleeves afresh and give it our all. But with dearth of evidence of the president matching those words of inclusiveness with action more than 1 year down the lane, many simply see a return to the old order. This is the root of the renewed clamor for equity and fairness in the polity, especially in the area of appointments. Towards promoting national unity and cohesion, Section 14 of 3 of 1999 Constitution, as amended, provides that the composition of the government or any of its agencies and the conduct of its affairs should be carried out in such a manner as to reflect the federal character of Nigeria and the need to promote national unity and also to command national loyalty, thereby ensuring that there shall be no predominance of persons from a few states or from a few ethnic or other sectional groups in that government or in any of its agencies. Section 15 of 4 of the Constitution also provides that the states shall foster a feeling of belonging and of involvement among the various people of the Federation, to the end that loyalty to the nation should override sectional loyalists. But this does not even seem to be the case. Few days before the 60th independence anniversary of Nigeria, the Human Rights Writers Association of Nigeria Uriwa while responding to alleged secret recruitment of the department's state service, maintained that the federal character was dead under President Muhammadu Buhari administration. There were reports that DSS had given 335 slots to Northerners, while the South got 93 candidates in the secret recruitments. A statement signed by Uriwa's national coordinator, Emmanuel Nwabiko, and the National Media Affairs, Ms. Zainab Yusuf, read in parts. We reiterate that in the last 5 years, the current administration of President Muhammadu Buhari has planted animosities between different ethnic nationalities than even the civil war created, and that is it will take the grace of God and the will of overpower in the will to overpower our differences for Nigerians to rebuild the bridge of unity that the elective administrative style of President Muhammadu Buhari has destroyed in the last 5 years. We shall continue to express our apprehensions over deep-seated northern domination of all strategic federal government recruitments and appointments under President Muhammadu Buhari, and that the next government may need to provoke a year-long national constitutional conference to try to mend the deeply broken fences. Uriwa also reacted in similar way to the president's earlier nominations of Aisha Umar as the Director General of the National Pension Commission. The rights group said fresh appointments to fill vacancies in the National Pension Commission also create uproar in the floor of the Senate on Tuesday because the president's Muhammadu Buhari to Northern Muslim bands. In June, the former military governor of Kaduna State, Colonel Abubakar Danjiwa Umar, in an open letter to President Muhammadu Buhari, warned that lopsided appointment is in his government was against the provision of the constitution and could spell doom for the country's unity. All those who wish you and the country well must mind no words in warning you that Nigeria has become disastrously polarized and risk sliding into crisis on account of your administration lopsided appointment, which continues to give undue preference to some sections of the country over others. The story is not any different in managing appointments at the National Oil Company, the Nation National Petroleum Corporation in March, the Niger Delta leaders under the aegis of Pan-Nigerian Delta Forum. Thank you, viewers, for listening to this news. Viewers, you have heard it all from the writer. You have heard what President Muhammadu Buhari has just done to the ethnics, the nepotism he has fueled for the call for breakup. What do you have to say concerning that? Your comment concerning this news is very much important. If you can drop them below the comment box, click on the subscription button as well as the bell button to receive notifications whenever I publish any new videos. And please don't forget to like and also share this news with friends as well. Thank you. As you do, have a wonderful day. Bye.